नमो
डॉक्टर बाबा साहब अंबेडकर की जय।
सो थैंक यू वैशाली। सो वी विल गेट स्टार्टेड विद द प्रोग्राम। सो वी हैव अ बिग लाइन अप ऑफ बिग इवेंट्स व्हिच वी कैन कॉल व्हिच वी हैव प्लान्ड फॉर टुनाइट। सो आई सी लॉट ऑफ पीपल अगेन वी आर ट्राइंग टू गेट इन, बट आई वुड अगेन रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू फॉलो द गाइडलाइंस व्हिच वी हैव सेट अप। With that, we will get started. So, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar's legacy have crossed many hearts and many countries. Today, we will go with our first speaker, Mr. Andre Manhurst. He is originally from Jamaica, but he is now residing in Canada, Toronto, and he would like to share some thoughts about Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Andre, are you ready?
Yes, Jai Bhim. Yes, so it's a pleasure to be a part of this meeting. It is an honor. Ever since I came to know about Dr. Ambedkar and just Buddhism in general, I have just come to love it. So thank you guys for having me for this meeting. So like, as you know, Dr. Ambedkar, you know, he was born on the 14th of April, 1891. He was born in the Mahar caste. Before meeting my wife, Rajeshri, and I've never heard of Dr. Ambedkar before. And she's the one actually that introduced me to Dr. Ambedkar, because, I mean, I don't know if you know, but you probably must know, but most of the people in the West, they know about Gandhi. And I've never heard about Baba Saheb before I met her. I mean, after I heard about Dr. Ambedkar, you know, and reading about his work and just everything that he's done for India. I can tell you, it's a very inspirational story, a very inspirational person. He has affected my life in a significant way. Anybody that studies Dr. Ambedkar, they can literally they can never be the same again. Like, just the way that you look at life, and just the things that you can accomplish, especially for your fellow man. Baba Seb exemplifies just the ultimate, test of character, the ultimate person, it's almost next to Jesus himself. Like, if anyone knows about Christianity or any sort of person that has exemplified excellence, you can say that Baba Seb is probably next to that person. So I wanted to, talk about women's rights, because Dr. Ambedkar, he did the Hindu Code Bill for women's rights. It was rejected in Parliament, but nevertheless, he fought for women's rights. And one of the reasons why I wanted to talk about women's rights is because if it wasn't for Dr. Ambedkar, I would not have met my wife here. because women now have freedom of movement, freedom to inherit property, freedom of speech, all of these rights that women have, Indian women especially have, is because of Dr. Ambedkar's work and what he did for the Indian constitution. So I just wanted to honor Dr. Ambedkar by celebrating what he did for women, celebrating women's rights. And I would just want to encourage everyone to, as we go throughout life, that we speak about Dr. Ambedkar a lot, because a lot of people in the Western world, they don't know about Dr. Ambedkar. They're probably just getting introduced to him now, because I think York University has a bust of Dr. Ambedkar in Toronto. But still, not a lot of people know about Dr. Ambedkar. So the more you speak about him, is the better, especially for people in the Western world. So, once again, thank you very much for having me speak. And today I would like to honor Dr. Ambedkar's birthday by celebrating women's rights and celebrating what he did for women in India. Thank you.
Thank you, Andre. I concur with you that even today, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar's thought are shaping the life of millions across the globe. So with that, we will keep the theme of Canada Toronto and go to our next speaker, which is Ajit Lear. And his topic would be Ambedkar mission in the Toronto and their activities. So Ajit ji, are you there? You might be on mute.
Yeah, I need to unmute. Now, okay, I think. Are you listening to me, please?
Yes, please go ahead.
सबसे पहले तो सभी अंबेडकर वर्ल्ड को मेरी तरफ से ग्रैंड सल्यूट, जय भीम, नमो बधाया। तो बहुत बहुत बधाई हो 129th जो बाबा साहब की बर्थ एनिवर्सरी आज हम थ्रू साइबर के मना रहे हैं आप सभी लोगों को। तो मैं अंबेडकर मिशन टोरंटो से या बुद्ध बिहार से अजीत ली बोल रहा हूँ। तो टाइम बहुत कम है। बाबा साहब की एक कोटेशन याद आ रही है मुझे, उन्होंने कहा था कि जब तक हम सामाजिक स्वतंत्रता हासिल नहीं कर लेते, उसके अलावा कोई भी कानून आपको स्वतंत्रता दे उसका कोई मायने नहीं रहता। तो बाबा साहब की इसी बात को मैं थोड़ा आगे बढ़ाना चाहता हूँ। तो उसका मायने क्यों नहीं रहता, तो हमें क्या करना चाहिए बाबा साहब के विचार के हिसाब से? बिना शक हमें धर्म क्रांति को बहुत आगे बढ़ाना है, पड़ेगा। इसके अलावा कोई हमारे पास और कोई चारा ही नहीं है। हमें भारत को बाबा साहब के सपनों का, जो बाबा साहब चाहते थे कि बुद्धमय भारत बने, ऐसा हमें ये पूरी कसम लेनी पड़ेगी कि हमें जो बाबा साहब का जो बुद्धमय भारत है उसको हमें हर हालात में और कोशिश करनी चाहिए कि हम कुछ ना कुछ कर सके। मैं इसके एग्जाम्पल देना चाहता हूँ कि जो सिख कम्युनिटी है, सिर्फ इंडिया में 2% से भी मैं मानता हूँ कम है, लेकिन उसकी जो इंडिया में डोमिनेशन है, आप जान सकते हैं कि 2% सिख पूरी इंडिया को लीड कर रहे हैं। तो तो हमें भी एज ए बुद्धिस्ट जो बाबा साहब ने बोला है कि हमारा जो इतिहास है, जो हमारा इतिहास है बुद्धमय इतिहास है, हम पहले कौन थे, ठीक, जब बाबा साहब ने बोला है कि व्हाट इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया, द बैटल बिटवीन ब्राह्मणिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म। सो हमें अब तक की यह समझ नहीं आई कि बुद्धा क्रांति की तरफ हम बहुत कम बात करते हैं। बाबा साहब की बात तो करते हैं, लेकिन बाबा साहब का जो धम दिया है उसकी तरफ हम बहुत ही धीरे धीरे बढ़ रहे हैं। तो मेरा आप सभी से ही, अंबेडकर वर्ल्ड से ये कहना है कि अगर हमें भारत में तरक्की चाहिए, भारत का अच्छा राज चाहिए, अशोका का राज चाहिए, तो हमें जो धम्म क्रांति है उसके ऊपर काम करना पड़ेगा। जो अंबेडकर मिशन टोरंटो और बुद्ध विहार पूरे वर्ल्ड के साथ, पूरी दुनिया के साथ मिलकर काम करना चाहता है। नमो बुद्धाय, जय भीम। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
जय भीम एंड थैंक यू अजीत जी। द नेक्स्ट वी विल गो टू भैया सोंडावले एंड हिज टॉपिक वुड बी यूनिटी इन चैलेंजिंग टाइम्स। भैया जी, आर यू रेडी?
जय भीम एंड नमो बुद्धाय ऑल। इट्स अ ग्रेट प्लेजर टू जॉइन विथ यू ऑल ऑन द 129th जयंती सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ अवर सेवियर एंड इमेंसिपेटर डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर। We are celebrating Jayanti in a digital environment, which is more appropriate in the COVID-19 pandemic situation, and an opportunity to connect with you all globally. Thanks to ABAT team, you deserve the praise. When we celebrate the Jayanti, it is imperative for us to do our own introspection and analyze whether we are heading in the right direction and the path showed by Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar with his immense struggle and hard work. To me, the tool for that analysis and assessment is the three commandments, what I call them as success triangle, that is educate, agitate, and organize. So let us briefly brush the first two ideas of educate and agitate. Educate, we can say that we are heading in the right direction. However, there is a need to get ourselves educated on Baba Saheb's mission and his thoughts. We should read and learn more about Baba Saheb's ideology and strategy to strengthen our people and to move to the step two, that is agitate. Agitate does not mean to agitate physically. It is also a mental revolution. In Baba Saheb's world, gulamala gulamichi janiv karundya, म्हणजे तो बंड करून उठेल. दिस इज व्हॉट वी कॉल द एजिटेटेड स्टेट ऑफ माइंड. येस, वी डू रिक्वायर टू शो अवर स्ट्रेंथ थ्रू द प्रोटेस्ट, बट इट हॅज टू बी एज थॉटफुल अँड प्लान एज बाबा साहेब डीड द टू सत्याग्रहज, कालाराम मंदिर अँड चौदार तलाव. अदरवाइज इट वुड बी काउंटर प्रोडक्टिव्ह, विच मोस्ट प्रॉबेबली अवर एनिमी वॉन्ट्स टू डू अस. वी नीड अन एजिटेशन ऑफ थॉट्स इन अवर माइंड in order to move to the next stage, that is organize. This is my personal opinion that we are heading in the reverse direction when it comes to the organize. I saw the era of my father as they were so committed to the call given by Baba Saheb, adopted the new religion without knowing it, but with full faith and with full faith with their savior, joined the Republican Party of India, RPI, and as a child I have seen that great enthusiasm and moment under the banner of RPI. Where are we today? We lost our registration and recognition as a political party. Let's analyze on the economic front. The situation we saw in the COVID-19, sudden lockdown by the government and closing of all transportations, what happened? Laborers in metros and urban areas lost their jobs. No homes as they were living in the temporary sheds in the factories and warehouses, and no relatives. So they walked down over 100 to 200 kilometers to find support in their villages and relatives. Who are they? They are our own people. Yes, some local charities came to in their support, but can we say that that was an organized support? By all means, no. A paper published by Rajendra Jadhav with the title The Perspective of Dalit Inclusive Disaster Risk Reduction. This paper was published in the New York on August 7, 2018. He described the economic vulnerabilities and demanded consideration for the caste-induced vulnerabilities. As our people are the first and most severely gets affected, they are the last to get relief and sometimes are actively prevented from getting relief in the disaster and pandemic situation like this. So let's get organized under the wheel of Dhamma, adopt the wheel and spoke model to strengthen our community, develop an inclusive culture of Dhamma, achieve our legacy as ancestors of Samrat Ashoka, and fulfill the dream showed by our Baba Sahib Ambedkar. Thank you very much. Jai Bhim and Namo Buddhaya.
Thank you, Bhaiya Ji. I definitely agree that we need to definitely fulfill the two cones of the triangle, which is organize and agitate. So thank you for your thoughts. So with that, we will now move to our young Ambedkarite from Atlanta, Georgia. Her name is Sakshi Chauhan. She is just 15 years old. And the topic she would be talking would be keep the lamp of spreading awareness of liberty, equality, fraternity, justice, ideology, always burning. She is the daughter of our own Sandeep Chauhan. Sandeep ji or Sakshi, if you are ready.
Yes, I'm ready. Jai Bhim, everyone. My best wishes to you on this occasion of Mahatma Phule Jayanti and Baba Saheb Ambedkar Jayanti. So, two men, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule and Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Two times, Mahatma Phule on 11th April 1827 and Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar on 14th April 1891. One mission, keep the lamp of spreading awareness of liberty, equality, fraternity, and justice ideology always burning. One purpose, establishment of a society based on liberty, equality, fraternity, and justice. One focus, focus on a single, clearly defined life goal and make achieving this goal their only purpose. One commitment, dedicate their whole life for working unconditionally for this mission 24/7. One message, educate, agitate, organize. After so many sacrifices of our founding fathers and mothers from Buddha to Baba Saheb, now people understand the purpose and significance of non-stop spreading awareness. Awareness amongst the masses is the necessary precondition for any kind of revolution to take place. During Buddha's times, the society was not as sophisticated and complex as was during Baba Saheb's and Mahatma Phule's times. It also seems true that the current times are much more complex than it was ever before. Spreading awareness is not an easy task. Spreading awareness means understanding these complex times and making our masses aware of things going on around them. The awareness that will lead to the creation of a society that our forefathers fought for. A society based on liberty, equality, fraternity, and justice for all. Now I want to take this opportunity to tell you a short story. Although the source isn't verified, it is very much worth knowing. Once someone asked Baba Saheb Ambedkar, what is the biggest accomplishment of your movement? Few people expected Baba Saheb to say it is the Constitution of India. Few people expected him to say the abolition of untouchability. Few expected him to say the reservations. And few expected him to say the religious conversion. But Baba Saheb Ambedkar said, the biggest accomplishment of my movement is I have put life into dead people. I have aroused self-respect in people. And I have inculcated a feeling in them to fight for their honor, their freedom, and their rights. For us, Baba Saheb is not just an individual, but he's an institution. In his own words, self-respect and self-help movement has nothing to lose, but everything to gain. Together we can, with a motto of one for all and all for one. Today, let's be aware, be safe, and be there for each other and society at large. Together is the best place to be. Thank you, Jai Bhim, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Sakshi, for such an enlightened speech. We are definitely proud to have such a knowledgeable and educated next generation. And with this, I have no doubt that Ambedkar's caravan is in the good hands. So with that, we would like to welcome our first guest speaker, Mr. Kushal Barmate, who is joining us from Bengaluru in India. So just to give a little background about him, he has completed his mechanical engineering from VRC, which is now called VNIT from Nagpur. And then he did his post-graduation diploma in management from IIM Ahmedabad in the year 1986. After that, he joined HAL and he served there for 36 years. And he retired from HAL as a general manager for the helicopter MRO division. He's also been a visiting professor at Jain University in Bengaluru, of teaching MBA and MTech students. At present, he's engaged with Genser Aerospace and IT Private Limited in Bengaluru as Director of Operations. Today, his speech is Thoughts on Navyan, which is also known as Bhimyan Buddhism, propounded by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar himself. So with that, Barmate ji, are you ready?
Are you able to hear me now?
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay. My dear Ambedkarite brothers, sisters, boys and girls, Jai Bhim, Namo Buddha. As he has explained, my name is Kushal Barmate. I'm joining from Bangalore to this function. First of all, I'm really thankful to the organization, Ambedkarite Buddhist Association of Texas, for giving me this opportunity to speak on this occasion of 129th birth anniversary of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. Just a few minutes back, we had taken refuge in Triple Jains and taken five precepts, that is Trisaran and Panchsila. In the exactly same way, Dr. Ambedkar had got converted. And then in turn, he had converted many of his followers, approximately 380,000 followers that day. And in turn, then in nearby areas, people were converted by resorting to refuge of Triple Jains and Panchsila precept. The same method is adopted all over the world also, particularly in Theravada Buddhism. Before I speak on Navayana Buddhism, let me give you a little more background of myself, though most of the things here Mr. Kamlesh has talked about. This relates to the today's talk, what I prepared for. So it is you will be able to relate it properly if I tell you my background, how I came into contact with Buddhism. I was born in a place called Dungargarh, that is in area in Chhattisgarh, which is slightly nearer to Bhilai. So it is not exactly midway from Nagpur to Bhilai, but it is in between that. So I was born in 1st of April 1951. That is the 5 years before the conversion undertaken by Dr. Ambedkar. My parents were residents of Nagpur in area called Indora, which is thickly populated place of erstwhile Mahal, now the Buddhist Ambedkarites. In fact, their surname was Walde. My surname Barmate is given to me by my grandfather from my mother's side, who had no son. When I was very young, I was taken every year to the Nagpur. Sometimes, I had to spend with my parents also. But major part of time was spent in Dongargarh, where I studied up to 11th standard. There are some instances which becomes part of your permanent memory. One such instance I remember even now, though I was 5 years old, is that one afternoon, many of ladies in our locality got into some small groups and they were weeping, saying, Baba has died. By hindsight, I can say that the day was 6th December 1956. And I happened to be in Nagpur that day. That was just 6 weeks after the conversion of Dr. Ambedkar. I don't distinctly remember when for the first time I recited Trisaran and Panchsila. But it was during a function held in Dongalgarh, maybe a marriage function or so, and when I was about 15 years old, that was the time when I was told that we are this. I did not realize the importance, but it created some curiosity to know about Buddha and Buddhism. Incidentally, in that period, my grandfather had taken up a newspaper agency. So many of the books used to come, you know, magazines and newspapers, etc. And that kind of thing helped me to read quite a lot about everything. So all the stories I went through, and I could get a booklet of Buddhist prayers. So I read that, by-hearted Tisrana, Panchasila. And in every functions which were conducted in that area by our people, I used to be present at that time. But from textbooks, I came to know that there are two sects in Buddhism, one Hinayana and other Mahayana. Later, when I was doing my engineering in Nagpur, I came in contact with a lot of Buddhist ceremonies, and which created some more interest to know about that. But somehow I got the impression that we are following Hinayana Buddhism or Theravada Buddhism. After joining HAL in Bangalore in 1973, first time I could see the prejudices prevalent in gross level. In fact, the organization was known among the employees as Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. In fact, it was dominated by those Aeyas, you know, the Brahmin community from the South India. And they were so prejudiced, and those prejudices were more apparent when it came to promotions of our people. You know. I came to know that till 2 years back, before my joining, even HL was not inducting any of the SCSTs in officer's grade. And it was due to effort put in by one of my senior engineering college students who went up to Jagjivan Ram and got it, you know, after fighting, he got HL to make this change and induct our people. So that is how I had joined HL. Later, I worked in other units of HL, and of course, I got married in the same ceremony like Buddhist practices. When I was in Koraput place in Orissa, After that, I joined one more unit of HL, Kanpur, where I took 2 years study leave and did my post graduation from IIM Ahmedabad. At IIM Ahmedabad, I came across another sect of Buddhism, which is called Nichiren Shoshu. This an organization called Soka Gakkai is a group of lay followers in that sect. Out of my curiosity, I joined that also. And then I found they don't convert in this kind of formal way. They say you follow your own religion, but you practice chanting of Nammyo Ho Rengekyo. I think some of you might have come across this kind of thing, because these are well known in many Western part of the world also. So in their practice, instead of Buddha's image, they chant before a scroll which depicts six worlds, including Buddhahood. I suspect one such scroll is enshrined in Dragon Palace Temple also in Gampi. The temple known at Taisekiji in Japan is the headquarters actually. The term Navayan I came across when I had started reading Ambedkar's book, the book Buddha and His Dhamma by Dr. Ambedkar. I found differing from the books of Narada Mahathera distributed by Mahabodhi Society in Bangalore. Some more searches on net, as the internet became common after 1996-97, led me to understand the difference as what was meant by Dr. Ambedkar's Buddhism. I thought of sharing Dr. Ambedkar's views on Buddhism, as many of you who are third generation Buddhist and have access to many writings of Dr. Ambedkar. You might have come across his Buddhism much earlier in your life compared to me. Dr. Ambedkar, on 13th October 1956, that is one day before the conversion, in a press conference held at Sham Hotel, Nagpur, stated, "I will accept and follow teachings of Buddha. I will keep my people away from different opinions of Hinayana and Mahayana, two religious orders, or Buddhism is Navayana. Navayana Buddhism, as envisaged by Baba Sahib in his magnum opus, The Buddha and His Dhamma, shows his critical stance towards the existing social practices. He radicalized Buddhism as a social message. Ambedkar found following beliefs and doctrines of Buddhism as problematic. First is relating to Buddha's Parivarja story. Then next is the doctrine of Four Noble Truths. Third, Anatta, Karma and Rebirth. And about the Bhikshu Sangha. He had entirely different radicalized opinion about this doctrine. Buddha's Parivarja, as tradition believes that Prince Siddharth one day saw a sick man and old man, a dead body in that sequence. Then he left his princely life and sought insight and a way out of human suffering. According to Ambedkar, this was absurd. He proposed that he was involved in making peace among tribes between Sakyas and Kolians. If you read Buddha and His Dhamma, in the first few introductory parts, this thing comes out very clearly. Four Noble Truths, this is the second problem which he thought is created by the doctrine of Four Noble Truths, or Four Arya Satya. Ambedkar believed that this core doctrine was flawed because it denied hope to human beings. According to him, the Four Noble Truths is gospel of pessimism, and many have may have been inserted into Buddhist scriptures by wrong-headed Buddhist monks of a later era. They should not be considered as Buddha's teaching. Third principle are the doctrine about anatta, karma and rebirth. This was again, he found, a flawed doctrine. Anatta relates to no self or no soul concept. Ambedkar believed that there is inherent contradictions between three terms. Either anatta is incorrect or there cannot be karma and rebirth in anatta. Ambedkar considered karma and rebirth as superstition. Then he had a very critical view of the Bhikshu Sangha. He says a Bhikshu is a member of monastic practice in historic tradition. But according to Dr. Ambedkar, this is a flawed idea and practice. He proposed Bhikshu Sangha to be made an organization of social service. That means they should go and actively participate in society and spread Buddhism. Here in Bangalore, when I had come back in 96, we from Nagpur area, the Vidarbhite, we had formed one group, and that is known as Samyak Prabodhan Pratisthan. Initially, we started with very small number of families, but now it has grown in very big size. And there are 200 families who are a member of this. And their aim is to spread Buddhism and remain united. But we all meet in a place called the Mahabodhi Society. And they follow Theravada Buddhism. I feel if you want to become a part of global Buddhist society and all that, we may not remain that rigid what Dr. Ambedkar wanted us to follow, and we should consider them as one of the sects and our brethren also. And that is how we can become the part of the total Buddhist societies all over the world. That is my thinking. I will now sign up and wishing you all the best for all your efforts. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Thank you, Barmati sir. First of all, thank you for taking through your memory lanes. And then providing the insight about what Baba Sahib thought about Buddhism. So thanks again. So with that, we will now move to, I would like to invite basically Sachin Mali and Sheetal Sate from Satara, India. They are going to entertain us with few of the songs. And we have time boxed this program again because we are running a little behind from our original schedule. So they would be entertaining us for 10 minutes. So Sachin or Sheetal, are you ready?
They are muted, I believe.
Yes, Shirish or Sheetal? Yeah, we can hear you, Sheetal.
Yes. Good night, Namo Buddhaya to all my friends. We are cultural activists, and Sheetal Sate, he is Sachin Mali, and he is Anupit Mohit. We are cultural activists. Our group name is Navayan Mahajalsa. We are working in Maharashtra and all India also. We are singing songs from you all of an occasion of Bhim Jayanti, but a song in Marathi, so hopeful you understand. I play song.
Ah
Thank you.
Jai Bhim. Thank you, Sachin and Sheetal. That was definitely a mesmerizing performance. I know everyone is on mute, but if given a chance, you will hear non-stop applause. It was definitely awesome. So thank you again.
Thank you.
So with that, we will move to our next young generation Ambedkarite who would like to talk to us about Baba Sahib.